Good morning, students. Students, we are going to start with the chapter that is metals and nonmetals. Students, you must have studied about metals and nonmetals in your previous classes. But before starting with the chapter, I want to make you clear about some terms that we need to know for the better understanding of the chapter. These are very basic terms related to the chapter. Now, the thing which come in our mind is that how substances exist in nature. You all must have heard the terms atoms, molecules, elements, and compounds. Now, do all these mean the same or these terms are different? So students, I want to make you clear with all these terms. These all refer to different things. Now, what these are? The first is atoms. Atoms refers to the smallest indivisible particles of a substance, which may or may not have independent existence. For example, the atom of hydrogen is H. And the atom of oxygen is O. It cannot be divided further. Then the second thing is molecules. Molecules are formed by combination of two or more than two same or different kind of atoms. For example, in water, you can see that there are two different kind of atoms, hydrogen and oxygen. But if you just think of, like, if I write H2 only, then H2 contains two atoms of the same kind. Then what are elements? Element is the purest form of a substance to have independent existence. Means elements exist independently. And it is formed of only one type of atoms, like Cl2, O2, Na. These all are elements. Cl2 is the element of chlorine, O2 is the element of oxygen, and Na is the element of sodium. Then we have compounds. Compounds are formed when elements of different substances combine together chemically. For example, CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate, in this calcium, carbon, oxygen, these three combine to form a compound. So I hope all these terms are very much clear to you, that what is the difference between atoms, molecules, elements and compounds. Now, let us start with the chapter. Now, scientists have classified all the known elements into two broad categories. Now, see here what the word they have used, elements. And elements were what? Which have independent existence. So the substance which exists independently in the nature is categorized into two broad categories. And this categorization is made on the basis of their physical and chemical properties, which are metals and nonmetals. Now, let us firstly explain metals and nonmetals on the basis of their physical properties. So firstly, you should know that what is meant by physical properties. So physical properties refer to the properties like appearance, hardness, malleability, and ductility. Now, what all these things are? Appearance means how they are appearing, that whether they are shiny or whether they have a dull look. Hardness means whether they are hard, soft, all these. Malleability refers to that whether they are malleable or not. Malleable means the substance which is malleable is a substance which can be beaten up into sheets. when you can convert a substance into sheets, we say that the substance is malleable. Ductility refers to its capability to get converted into wire-like substances, like when you can make wires of that particular substance, then we say that that particular substance is ductile. So all these are the basis of differentiation between metals and non-metals, and all these come under physical properties. So for better understanding, try to complete the following table on the basis of their observation. Like I have three different materials: iron, coal, aluminium. Appearance, that whether they are shiny or dull, hardness, whether they are very hard or not hard, or they flattens on heating means they are malleable, or they breaks into pieces means they are non-malleable. So iron is shiny in appearance and very hard and it flattens. Coal, it is dull, not hard, and it breaks on beating. Aluminium is again shiny, it is also hard and it also flattens on beating. So all these are the different observations related to the strength and type of material we have. So on the basis of above observation, we can have difference in physical properties, which are as follows. So metals are the substances which are shiny in appearance, or we can say that they are lustrous. However, non-metals do not have luster. Metals are very hard, and non-metals, they are not hard. Metals have high density, non-metals have lower density as compared to metals. Metals are malleable, that is, can be beaten into sheets. However, non-metals, these break on hitting hard, so they are non-malleable. Metals are ductile, that is, they can be drawn into wires. And non-metals, as already told you, they are non-ductile. Then metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Non-metals are bad conductors of heat. Then one more important thing about metals is these produce sound on heating. That is, they are sonorous. Non-metals, on the other hand, they do not produce any sound, so they are non-sonorous. So students, these are the differences in the physical properties of metals and non-metals. This finishes with the today's lecture. Kindly go through the video properly, listen it once or twice, and try to solve the follow-up worksheet. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay safe.